Okay, now you're focused.
Look at the big nerd with the camera. Charlie, don't. This is a memory for life that you shall treasure forever. Yes, you too can have a copy of Mark Juggling for only $19.95.
Scoot back some. Oh.
I'd rather move.
You're too old.
Fine, just insult my age. Because I've been in your service for nigh on 60 years now.
It's all right. You'll do well under my stroker.
Have a roll.
I think I'll wait. Go out.
Send me away! You've been gone all these days. They've seemed like years. Did you just send me off like that? Cast me like driftwood.
I'll see you to the dungeon shortly, my man.
My great pleasure
bestow upon you. Sir Jester, what is the problem? We are starting to...
Oh, my.
We have a funny man in white face. Back.
Ladies, lords and ladies, it is with great deal of privilege and pleasure that I bestow upon you the lord of our castle. Lord Parker, you have returned, sir.
Yes, but only for just a brief visit, sir. I've heard you've done so well the last two nights running this feast. Sir, and my lady and I, we have ridden many miles to be here. We are tired. Continue, sir. It is your feast.
Thank you, Lord Parker. My countrymen, we have hired the finest carolers in all of England, the finest instrumentalists in all of England, to perform for you tonight in the castle of Lord and Lady Parker. Most of you have heard Lord Parker was called away to the king and has returned to us. We are very grateful and very privileged to bestow upon you his privilege and his presence this evening. Let the feast begin. Gentlemen, was the hunt for the boar's head successful? Is all in order for the presentation of the boar's head procession?
Yes, Master Kruger, the hunt was successful. May we present the boar's head procession?
Let the procession begin. Gentlemen, you have done well in your hunt. Take the boar's head to its place of honor on the mantle. Special ensemble perform as the rest of the wassail is being served. Thank you, Sir Brent.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm.
I'm sure you want to record this song.
Mm-hmm.
Jenny.
Yes, Wes.
All are served.
Thank you. My countrymen, Lord Parker, my lady and I would be most honored if you would stand and join us in the Christmas toast. What is this? Wes, what is the problem? In the wassail. They did this last night. What is the problem with the jesters?
Can't you keep a cover on it or something?
What? Enemy! I do.
Take them to the dungeon and dry them out.
Really good.
Brent, is all in ready for the next presentation of song?
Yes, Meister Kruger, it is.
Lord Parker, with your permission?
You have it, sir.
Carolers, prepare yourselves. Thank you. fresh greens from our neighboring countries to the south. They have been very well selected. You may serve my guests. Rules of etiquette that Sir Jim is about to read to you.
The rules of etiquette. Guests must have their nails clean, or they will disgust their other table companions. Guests must avoid quarreling and making conversations with other guests. Guests must not stuff their mouths, but one who eats with haste. If he is addressed, he is scared to answer. Guests must not pick their teeth with a knife, straw, or a stick. Guests must not draw any unseemly tails to the table, not soil their cloth with a knife, nor rest their legs on the table. Guests must never leave their bones on the table. Always hide them under your chair. Guests must not wipe their greasy fingers on their beards. Guests must not lean on the table with their elbows, nor dip their fingers in their drinks. Guests must retain their knives, or they will be forced to rub with their fingers. And lastly, guests must never breathe fire or smoke from their nose or mouth, or they may find themselves stuck in the parking lot.
Thank you, Sir Jim.
Wait, are you finished?
Of course, sir.
You did a fine job, but you got the rules.
Sir Brent, he forgot the rule of the salt.
I think we must do something with him.
Take him to the jester training ground.
that is a
new fool for next year. Sir Brent, if you would, yes, carry on with the rule of the salt, please.
As everyone knows, salt is very, very precious. All the way from the Middle East by camel. That is, until it reaches the English Channel. At each table, the eldest male is to be known as the keeper of the salt. Everyone else at the table must ask the keeper's permission to use the salt. If you are caught disobeying the rule of assault, either one of two things will happen. You can be thrown into the moat with the alligators, or we can have you stand along with your table and sing one verse of your favorite Christmas carol.
Thank you, Sir Brent. Very well done.
Thank you, my sir.
For you at this time, you would direct your attention to the front stage area. Sir Mark, is all in ready?
My finger. Hey, Mike.
I forgot to give a name of one of the key donors that are here this evening to Lord Parker. Pardon me, Lord Parker. I'd like to recognize the Hepner family who also donated towards the grand piano. My apologies to them. If I might try to continue now, Lord Parker. Sir Brent, is the next performance group ready?
Yes, I believe so.
Thank you. Thank you.
is calling. Sing we Noel, Noel, Noel. Sing we Noel, Noel. Out in the air so crisp and clear, Christmas Lord is calling.
Hey, sir.
Oh, wait.
Lord Parker, we are indeed very privileged to have this magnificent instrument to perform with, and that is one of the reasons why the dinner concert music was selected with the piano interludes and introductions, so that we could kind of feature that. There is an additional key donor that I was made aware of that is here with us this evening. I apologize to them for not recognizing them earlier. Mr. and Mrs. Crum, if they would please stand and be recognized and take our special thanks and apologies also to our for meeting you earlier. We do appreciate your support.
Thank you. fucking maze.
Because the Lord's feast is in progress, and sire, we did not know you were coming.
Good reason. I did not know I was coming. The wrong turn. Anyway, I had to have dinner at McBarkburger's. Whatever that event. But these two fine young gentlemen, sweet little boys they are. Sweet little boys they are. Brought me here for this feast.
Good, Sir King.
I am in quest of...
But sire, your carriage came for him on Friday evening, just before our feast began. Took him to your castle, and just this evening he returned from your castle. We thought he was back with us.
Oh.
Is he not back with us permanently, King?
No, I want him with me and his lovely wife. Lady Parker.
I can understand that.
I have a grand, grand announcement to make to all of my loyal subjects here at Lord Parker's castle. I have a grand announcement. I wish to make a grand announcement this evening that Lord and Lady Parker will be joining me for a short visit, 9 months, at my castle. And then
yes,
he shall assume the position of Lord High Chancellor at the Kingdom of the North. His principalship shall be there, and he shall be removed from this castle. But fear not. Fear not, I in my benevolence, right? I in my benevolence will appoint a new lord of this castle here. And you can rest assured that he will be someone equally as sobering and as stern and as gifted in principles as possible in this castle here. However, before we do that...
Will you still have a
job? Get up and stop squibbling on my pantyhose. Yes, you both will have a job at least for 9 months.
Oh, thank you.
Now, Maestro.
Yes, King.
Would you please escort Lord Parker to my presence and bring the sword of the Glen with you?
My privilege, Lord King.
Ah, yes.
Just do it.
Well, that's coming. Let me see who's here.
This way.
That's you, young man. Bedchamber person? Yes. Anything. Do they have good cooks?
Why Jamon? Stand forth.
Ah, quiet. Elf, quiet. Come in before me. My most valued lord of all the land, who has for years, 11 I believe, served here at the Glen and this wonderful castle. My wonderful dear Lord Parker is here, and I wish this evening... I wish.
But I always forget. I do this with the right hand. The right hand.
Ah! Lord Parker, having served me very well for a number of years, 11, north, wilt thou kneel? Lord Parker, in this very sobering and solemn occasion, we wish to knight you, Lord High Chancellor of the Kingdom of the North. Arise and take thy command. To the Kingdom of the North, where he shall serve in part and parcel and in principalship as my voice in the Kingdom of the North. Oh, I love you dearly and for your splendid support. Oh, but wait. I, in this year, am so generous. We, in the spirit of the holiday season, wish to present to Lord Parker a small token of what we have borrowed from the peasants. Lord and Lady Parker, for 11 years of service to us here in the Glen, and for standing firm with your principle, we present this gift to you and your lovely lady. Go ye from here and serve me well, or she'll end in jail. You're dismissed. You're dismissed, and you too, my dear. And now, what do I do with this thing? I've always cut my finger on it. Maestro!
Yes,
King. Take that!
Thank you.
Now, my dear subjects, I must go, because on the way here I found a cute little filly, a two-legged one, and I have to go do some kingly work. Jesters, find my way out of this place fast.
This way.
Yes, this way. This way. A Merry Christmas to all, and God bless ye.
La 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 la. Can't you little freshman wait? La 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 la.
Chancellor, if you would rise with me, please, sir. Our finest desserts for you lords and ladies that are visiting with us this evening. You may serve my guests.
You haven't worn this thing all night.
Wench, Amy.
Yes,
I thought we discussed this the last two evenings, Wench Amy. The head table is to be served first.
Wench Terry's fault, sir.
Is she with the king?
I think so.
If you could take care of the head table, and where is the young wench that is to play the flute solo?
One chair.
Thank you, Sir Larry. If we could have the flute solo, please. Lords and ladies, as you are enjoying your dessert, we would like to present the flute solo.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah. Oh, you guys are making me sick. Dum dum dum.
Thank you.
Oh,
it's so
much more.
Here she is.
Thank you, Larry. You can go back for
it. Thanks, sir.
Now,
what's
this?
Yes, Sir Mike.
I cannot play this by myself. This is written for two people.
Oh, Sir Mike.
I'm sorry, Lord Kruger. Can we have Sir Martin?
Sir Mark, if you would help Sir Mike. It's a good thing, Lord Parker, we have a large new piano. If you would look over that and be ready to start. Sir Brent, are the carolers ready?
Yes, we are.
Those Lord in the Brent, back, wait. Yes. What is the problem now?
This thing is written for one more hand. We need five hands for this song.
How can you have five hands on one keyboard?
How would I know? It's right here.
Got a part written for the page turner.
Oh, the page turner gets to play. Well, with
Wench Shannon.
Wench, yes, Wench Shannon.
Come here, Wench.
Lords and ladies, the passionate shepherd to his lover.
And we will sit upon the rocks, seeing the shepherds feed their flocks, the shallow rivers to whose falls melodious birds sing madrigals.
Melodious birds sing madrigals.
And I will make thee bend of roses, and a thousand finger posies, a cap of flowers and a kirtle, embroidered all with leaves of myrtle.
Embroidered all with leaves of myrtle.
Oh.
Lord Chancellor.
I hope that you are now feeling a little bit more in the mood for Christmas. 11 years for a nice way to start the Christmas season. Without a doubt, one of the finest group of kids that we can put together for you. I'd like to thank several different groups tonight for planning and...
Parker has mentioned the parents. I would like to also thank all of you that have parents involved with the students. If you noticed, when the parents stood, it was not all of the crowd. That's what the amazing thing is about the production of this feast. Over three nights, we served just under 900 people this year. There's a lot of you friends, guests, alumni that have come to be a part of this, and we appreciate your support also. But especially parents, I very much appreciate your support. I'd like to thank also King Taylor. If he would please stand, Mr. Taylor. Mr. Taylor is very dear to all of us in the choir progs, loaned us their bells for most of our rehearsing and two of the performances. And then tonight we also thank Mrs. Davidson and the Amelia Methodist Church. Mrs. Staker is the director of our bell choir. The bell choir is made up of students within the choir, and we have a special gift we'd like to present to her at this time. At this time, I would like to, from the choir, also present, since the king presented the last gift, we'd like to present a special gift to Lord Chancellor now and Lady Parker, if they would stand. And I think the easiest way to do this, Lady Kruger, if you would present the gift, it is over there, I believe.
Oh, thank you very much.
Thank you.
Nice photograph.
10th anniversary production last year. Lord Parker mentioned in the food service, and we also have a number of very, very talented soloists. They are all excellent singers and sometimes a little nervous, but also very excellent in their performance. It takes a lot of courage to stand up in front of not only mom and dad, but a lot of people that they don't know. But we'd like to recognize at this time our three accompanists that helped us out so much this evening. If they would come down and be recognized. Four accompanists, that's right. They would come down and be recognized at this time. In your program, you will see part of we have one member of the setup committee we would like to recognize at this time. I didn't get the award built in time, and it will be presented at a later date. We have what we are going to now call the Falling Ladder Award. As I mentioned, all of the decorations, everything is student taken care of. And Thursday evening, as everything was going up, something came down. There wasn't luckily, and I think the second thing that we asked him after we found out, make sure all of his body was okay, was his throat okay? Because as you notice, he is our lead tenor. Mr. Tobergta left some scratch marks partway down the wall back there as he came down with the ladder. But we're glad he's healthy. Thank you. There are two more groups of people within the organization I need to recognize. The first one are the officers in charge of the entire production. Our treasurer is Jenny Buzak. Our secretary is Mary Jonas. The associate producer Production chairperson, actually, is the wench, Amy Galey. And the head steward and associate producer, who will probably, this position will take over as producer next year as I move completely to the head table, and that is the president, Mr. Brent Rice. And we also would like to recognize our flute soloist at this time, and that is Susan Roberts.
Put it on tape right now, Mama. Come on.
It ain't on tape.
Your little red light on?
Recording nothing.
That me, I'm recording all these things. I'm recording all kinds of stuff.
Uh-oh.
Yeah, I'm